The battle over a casino in southeastern Wisconsin is playing out over the airwaves. The Menominee tribe wants to build a casino and entertainment complex in Kenosha, but Milwaukee leaders and the Potawatomi tribe, which operates a large casino in Milwaukee, are fighting it. Last week, we heard the argument for the casino from the Menominee tribe. This week, the argument against it. We're joined by Jeff Crawford, the Attorney General for the Forest County Potawatomi. It's good to have you on the program. Thanks
well, thank you, Mike.
With us. Well, let me give you a chance to do what we did with the Menominee last week, to make your case. You think it's a bad idea, Kenosha Casino. Why?
Absolutely, we think it's a bad idea. When you take a look at this application and the history of who was involved with it, you see that it is signed by a convicted felon who took bribes in order to get the support of the county for this agreement.
Is that ancient history? Let me just jump in there. Is that ancient history, though?
No, it's not ancient history, because those very same agreements that were supposed to have been negotiated by an honest public official dealing with multiple parties, multiple payments, are still in effect and will go into effect if this deal goes forward. So you have to ask yourself, when they were negotiating those dozens upon dozens of other fine points, including the allocation of millions of dollars to various entities within the Kenosha community, was that by an elected official that was being honest, or was that the elected official that took bribes to get this deal done?
Jobs, though, is the other argument you're making, that whatever gains the Menominee might have in terms of jobs will come at the expense of the Potawatomi. Bureau of Indian Affairs said it would be a modest impact on your casino. Are they wrong?
Absolutely, they're wrong. It's kind of curious to figure out what perspective the Bureau is coming from. On the one hand, they will say that, you know, in some respects, we are a model tribe, and we have accomplished is sort of what other tribes should be doing in terms of economic development and business decision making, and they completely disregard our business judgment. On the other hand, they will say that the Menominee have not been able to get their economy going, and they just have a hard time from a business perspective, and yet their business judgment is deferred to by the BIA. You need to understand that the underlying economic studies that they are relying on were paid for by Dennis Troa, another corrupt official, or not official, a developer that was doing the bribing and doing the campaign violations to get that project approved.
Briefly, how many jobs do you think are at stake for the Potawatomi should the Kenosha Casino be approved?
It's almost a one-for-one. You know, if you believe their tainted reports, they're going to generate about 1,000 or 3,000 or 3,500 jobs, and we and the city of Milwaukee will lose approximately 3,000 jobs. It's not just at our casino. It would have a ripple effect on the Milwaukee community in general.
What do you think is the current state of thinking of the governor? You've obviously expressed your dismay with this proposal. He has said he wants consensus from the tribes, all of the tribes in the state. Where do you think this stands?
Well, I think his position that he stated publicly is pretty clear, and he has taken, from my perspective, he's trying to balance a number of interests. One, local government. So he's saying that there needs to be local support. Obviously, there's support in the city of Kenosha and Kenosha County. There is not consensus when it comes to, you know, Milwaukee County, certainly Lake County, Illinois, other counties. So that right there tells you that at the local level, it's not a done deal, that's got complete support. He also says that there needs to be no net gaming increase,
right,
as part of this. He's taking into account in that policy position that Wisconsin as a whole has said we don't want to have an increase in the amount of gaming. We're okay with Indian gaming the way it is right now, but we just don't want to grow it. It's not good for the state. And the third point that he takes is that it needs to have tribal consensus. And again, what he's taking into account there is tribal government-to-government relations. Can they work this out? I think it's a reasonable position on his part.
I want to ask you a question about the ads we've been seeing, the enough already ads opposing the Kenosha Casino. Is your group helping fund that? Is the tribe helping fund those ads?
Absolutely not.
You're not paying that? There's no money from the Potawatomi going to fund those ads?
Nope, none whatsoever. I mean, to be honest with you, I haven't even seen the ads.
Do you know who's paying for them?
No, I do not.
You do not?
We are not the enough organization.
All right. And my final question is this. Is this not a simple matter of competition? Why shouldn't the Potawatomi and the Menominee both do what they're going to do and see what the market bears?
This is not an issue of competition, and you can take a look at the history of the Indian Gaming Regulatory Act and the gaming compacts in the state of Wisconsin. This is a heavily regulated and limited type of business. It was never intent to be free and open competition. If it were to be free and open competition, there would be 50, 100 casinos in the state of Wisconsin. The people of the state of Wisconsin said, we don't want that. So the balance was struck. The compacts are in place. This will upset that entire balance.
Jeff Crawford is the Attorney General for the Forest County Potawatomi. Thanks very much for being with us today.
Well,
we appreciate
you.
It.
Yep.
Next, a new plan for measuring school performance. Do we need it? And why are some voucher supporters skeptical? But first, here's the WISN Politics week ahead.
Governor Walker joins the governors of Illinois and Indiana at the Summit on Regional Competitiveness, Friday at the Federal Reserve Bank of Chicago.